So, just to hit the spectrum of defense, if I feel Cameron trying to pull me into close guard,
I always want to have one knee up, right? It's a good way to just make sure that I'm never inside someone's close guard. Maybe he used like a shin on shin and kicked my leg out, put my knee on the mat, and I find myself in close guard. It's like, okay, we need to be able to get out of here as well, right? We could use the belt. My preference is the pants, because the pants will stop at the hip line, right? If I lock my hands out here, the pants aren't going anywhere, whereas the belt can come untied. The belt can come all the way up to where my arms are overextended. I'm almost exclusively using the pants. And then my favorite way to stand from here, because are there ways to break the close guard from the knees? Yes, it's extremely difficult. I would almost exclusively stand to break the close guard. Almost every single time I put a close guard, I'm gonna try to stand. I'll do that by shifting my weight to one side or the other, so I can put my toes on the mat, start to elevate my foot, put my foot on the mat. Now I'll do the same thing, I'll lead to the left, put my right toes on the mat, and now I come up, and the guard is weakening, right? If it's still closed, I can cat-cow, start to bring my elbow to my knee, okay? Once I get my knee to the mat, stop right here and look at some ways to pass from here. That's how we'll be getting out of close guard. As soon as I get pulled in, I'm looking to get to the pants. As soon as I get to the pants, I lock my elbows out. And I don't want my head to move forward or backward. If my head moves backward, I'm susceptible to hip bumps. If my head moves forward, I'm susceptible to him controlling my posture. So as soon as I get the pants, I'm going to offset my weight so I can put my toes out. I roll to my foot, and I offset to the other side. Toes go out. I roll to my foot. And now I'm pressing his hips away. It's like my gorilla crawl. Cat-cow. I bring my elbow to my knee. I drag my knee to the mat. Everybody good with that? Can you see it again? No? One more time? Sure. So I get my strong grips. I'm locking my elbows out. This keeps my posture in a good position. Now I can lean my weight to one side, so I can turn my toes out, roll to my foot, and I'm leaning to this side. My other toes go to the mat, and I roll to my foot. I've already got the guard open. Now I can bring my knee to the mat on this side. Now I have his bottom leg trapped. Does that make sense to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Good yeah. Shot.
Yep. That's how I was. When you were engineering with the knee.
Yeah, I'll go from like an anterior pelvic tilt to posterior pelvic tilt with a little bit of a rounded spine. Because I'm just at that point fighting the lock of the ankles. So I put a little bit more pressure here for our locking the ankles. That's a good question. Anything else? Let's give it a shot. One, two, one, two.